Welcome to Beecham House.
Tarek's off to fetch the new arrival.
Who is it?
Very honoured to have you here.
The suites are in what we call the B wing.
Sounds like a prison.
What is this movie about? It's about living this life.
It's a comedy, I think. I think it's a comedy. Have you been told it's a comedy? Yeah, good.
Where? Fancy for a little rumpy pumpy, is this one?
Guess who said rumpy pumpy?
Boys, I know who it is. I saw her.
It is a star, but you'll never guess who.
The Astoria Quartet is a very simple one in a way. It's about four old opera singers who are in an old people's home. And to begin with, there are only three. And into this equation comes the ex-wife of Reginald. And this imperious figure is played by Maggie Smith.
They were married once, but it didn't work out.
When I was at the Scala, I had a fling. It was the biggest mistake of my life.
With Reggie, he doesn't like the fact that she's moving in. It's going to break his heart, you know, and I try and make it easier for him.
Jean, when she arrives, is the fourth member of the quartet that was sung by them when they were younger. And so the idea is that they perform the quartet from Rigoletto at the Gala, but Jean doesn't want to because she thinks her voice is gone. And it's how we persuade her to come on board.
And it's about getting Jean to sing and getting Jean and Reggie, you know, to reconcile after 40 years being apart.
It's very rarely that you get an even faintly romantic story for elderly people.
There's a quotation by Samuel Johnson, which is, as a man grows older, he should keep his friendships in good repair. And I think that's what Jean's character has not done. And I think that after she's got over the fact that she's better than all of the rest of us, her character, she realises the value of an old friendship.
Yeah, it's a bit of power of friendship and it's a bit of power of life itself and facing up to the fact that sometimes you're not what you thought you were and that other people sometimes are better than you, but that your best is good, you know, and that their best is enjoyable. It isn't something to fear.
I think people will take away an idea that there might be life after a certain age.
It's about surviving, and surviving with dignity.
It doesn't matter what age you are, you can still get a lot out of life, and I think that is one of, especially in Dustin's hands, going to be one of the great, you know, messages of the film.
Don't die until you die. You're alive until the very last second.
This short time that's given to you, don't be a schmuck and wait too late. When you're in an elevator, nobody looks at anybody. Everybody looks down. Hey, what's up? I never saw you before, and I'm never going to see you again. How you doing? You can tell me the truth. We only got a few seconds before you hit your floor. Bad day?
Whoever's in an old folks' home, if they got the fitness, they should start behaving badly. I think that's a good tip.
This is not a retirement home. This is a madhouse.